please, and don't try to hide. Or a silly spook may sit by your side, shrouded in a dark disguise. They pretend to terrorize. Grim, grinning ghosts come out to socialize. These cold fall months, these are a time when the days get shorter, when the nights get longer, it gets dark and cold, and we start to think about what makes us afraid. We start to think about the nature of fear, how it affects us, and about what things we should be afraid of and what we shouldn't. I know for a fact, facing your own fears can be terrifying. I did that a few years ago, 3 years ago now. I've never liked clowns. I find them creepy. They're unappealing. There's just something off about them. They're in that right in the uncanny valley. And I went to a clown-themed motel in the desert of Nevada, out in a town called Tonopah, really in the middle of nowhere. And I went and I spent 3 nights in that motel. The whole motel is filled with clowns, clown dolls, paintings of clowns. It's an old, creaky building that really hasn't had much upkeep. And it is in the middle of nowhere. If something happens to you, who knows how anybody will come help you. So I went out there. I got there late at night. I had reserved a room, and I went in. There's a really creepy clown up on the wall looking right at me. Clown painting right in front of the bed. But I tried to get some sleep. I had driven all the way through Death Valley, so I just turned off all the lights, and the wind is blowing the building. The whole building is kind of creaking with the wind. Oh, and there's an Old West Cemetery next to it also. There's an old cemetery where everyone who died violent, terrible deaths is buried there in that cemetery. But I tried to get to sleep. I kept waking up. I kept having terrible nightmares. And I would wake up. I'd hear noises from the neighboring rooms, too. People would be up walking around. And I'd wake up from my own nightmares. One of the times I was right around 3 a.m, I was drifting off, and I thought I heard a voice say my name, David, in my ear. It was my voice talking to me, David. It woke me up. And I looked at the clock, and I looked around, and I heard it. These footsteps coming from the room above mine, pacing back and forth, just from one end of the room to the other, pacing back and forth, really heavy footsteps. And I heard that, and I just tried to tell myself, now, there's nothing to be afraid of. Nothing to be afraid of. It's fine. It's just some other hotel guest. He can't sleep either. And maybe he's more creeped out than I am by this place. So he's just walking back and forth in his room. It's whoever is staying in the room above mine. And then I woke up a little more and I realized my room was on the top floor of that hotel. There were no other rooms above mine. I don't know what I heard that night, but it definitely wasn't a hotel guest. Facing your fears can be terrifying, but it can also be worth it. So that's what we're going to be looking at. We have 5 storytellers tonight, all of us sharing with you tales of creepy and macabre, tales of the unknown, tales of the unexplained. And so we're going to start off tonight. We're going to start off with Fred. Fred is going to be telling us The Cry, very macabre tale about a man in a dark alley. Then after that, we have Catherine. Catherine's going to be telling us the tale, An Old Woman's Charms. Then we'll be hearing from Marilyn. Marilyn is going to be telling Pennies on the Tracks, personal story about a scary story that was told to her when she was a child. Then we'll go on with Mindy. Mindy will be telling us stories of the Chaneques from Mexico, from Veracruz. The Chaneques, the little people, very mysterious creatures out in the wilderness. Then at the end, we'll come back with me, David, and I will be telling you the fortune teller's curse. So if you listen to these stories, and then if you go to bed tonight, and if you hear the wind blowing outside, or if you hear a creaking on the steps, or if you think you hear something in your room, just keep telling yourself, it's only a story. It's only a story. Enjoy.